This is now the easiest way to properly integrate KNX into your Crestron Home projects. I'm happy to introduce One Home Server CH for Crestron Home. First, let's talk about the why. Why did we create this device? Well, KNX often needs to be integrated into Crestron Home projects, but the experience of doing this leaves much to be desired. The configuration is very complex. It requires a lot of KNX knowledge and a lot of creativity to set up. There's no semantics and it takes a lot of time. But One Home Server for Crestron Home makes the whole process incredibly easy and straightforward. Okay, so we have set up One Home Server CH, we have connected it to KNX bus and logged in into the local dashboard. Here's how simple it is to import your KNX devices. You simply go to Add Device, and then you have two options. You can upload your ETS file and auto-import your devices, or if you need to do some tweaking or you want to add devices manually, you can do it right here. You choose which device type you want to import. So we have lights, dimming lights, color temperature lights, full color lights, thermostats, air conditioners, push buttons, various sensors. So really a lot of devices you can choose from. You simply click on create and then input your group addresses and we'll handle the rest. Now for this project, I have already imported my KNX devices and they're all listed in the dashboard, as you can see here. Now that we've imported our KNX devices into One Home, we can set up the Crestron Home integration. We go to Integrations and then click on the Configure button under the Crestron Home integration. And here we are presented with a password, which we will use to give the Crestron driver access to this One Home server and to establish a connection. Let's return back to this password after we have set up the driver on the Crestron Home side. Now we are in the Crestron Home Setup tool, and let's first click on Pair Devices, then on Drivers, then Platform. Let's go down to Crestron. And here we have the Crestron One Home driver. Let's select into which room it should be added. I will add it to the garage. Let's click on plus and let's name it One Home Server CH. Okay. And now we're presented with this pop-up. Here we have to add the IP address of One Home Server CH. And for the password, let's return back to the One Home dashboard and copy the password for the Crestron Home integration. So we copy this, we paste it, click on next, and now One Home Server CH is added to Crestron Home. And now all that's left to do is to arrange the integrated KNX devices into rooms in our Crestron Home project. So we select the room, let's select bathroom, then we go back. We click on Managed Platforms and we select One Home Server CH. And now we can add the devices from One Home Server CH into our room. Once you've added these KNX devices to Crestron Home, you can then use them across the Crestron Home system. So in the Crestron Home mobile app, in Crestron Home schedules, actions, and much more. You can learn more about how you can use these devices in Crestron Home in the documentation, which is linked below. What's really cool about our integration is that all KNX devices that are brought into Crestron Home via One Home Server CH are already properly configured with all the control points necessary. So let's take a look at a couple of examples here. If we take a look at the lights, we can see we have them all grouped in this room. We can turn them off or on altogether, or we can also get more specific, get some granular control. So for example, this is a color light where we can tune the white balance, or we can select any color we want. Then of course we can also dim the lights. We choose a specific percentage. Then next, if we take a look at AC control, we can control the mode, so heat or cool. We can set the temperature, and everything works near instantly. This is because One Home Server works completely locally, and so the response times are really, really fast. You can also monitor sensors in Crestron Home. So here we see that in the bathroom we have 53% humidity, and this of course comes from a KNX humidity sensor. And lastly, if we take a look at some shutters, we have controlled for the target lift in percentage. We also have some presets for fully open, fully closed. And if this device would have slats, this can also be controlled in Crestron Home. One Home Server CH also gives you more powerful tools to better manage your KNX projects. For example, you can enable remote access to your One Home Server, which lets you adjust configuration remotely. With remote access, you can also enable remote ETS programming, which makes it easy for you to remotely program your KNX installation from anywhere in the world. To keep everything organized, One Home Server also comes with a multi-project management system that lets you access all your One Home Server CH devices from all your projects in one spot. If you want to know more about that, the documentation is linked down below. And for any logics and KNX specifics that you need to handle, you can also use One Home Automations that is built into the One Home Server. There you can listen for KNX telegrams, device changes, you can do something with sunrise or sunset, you can check complex conditions, you can read and write data directly to KNX group addresses. And if you want to learn more about that, the video is linked in the corner right here. This has been a short overview of the One Home Server CH and how it can simplify and improve your workflow with KNX and Crestron Home. We can't wait for you to get this device in your hands, test it out and use it in your Crestron Home projects. The One Home Server CH is already available for purchase, but it is only available for our partner integrators. So to join the One Home Partnership Program, please follow the link in the description down below. This was it for today, and I'll see you next time.